Republican governor of New Jersey is sick and tired of hearing about one particular issue. Let's listen to the governor. So right there, he makes clear that it shouldn't be an issue because nobody should aspire to it. Well, yeah, I guess, I mean, nobody wants to be in the hospital, but we should care about the insurance industry. It's just stupidity there, and he's going to be attacked for it. But first, what's your response?
Yeah, I think that this goes to how much our politicians are stuck in their elite bubble.
Yes.
So for them, the only contact they have with anyone who's ever made minimum wage is their kids. So, like, maybe, oh, you know, instead of just handing Johnny a BMW, let's make him work for it. Let's make him go work at McDonald's and get minimum wage or whatever it is, right? But they don't know. A lot of Americans, they literally, isn't that amazing? He's the governor of a state. He doesn't realize that a lot of Americans work on minimum wage. That's their job. That's what they got to make a living on. That's why oftentimes, since it pays so little, they have to have two jobs at minimum wage just to survive. So for him, it's like, what's the big deal? So Johnny's getting $7 instead of $8. I mean, he's going to get all the money he wants anyway when you just give it to him,
yeah.
Right? But we don't all live in that world.
Yeah, and it also shows you not only are they insulated from the real world, right? Our representatives, our politicians, our lawmakers don't actually represent us, right? When you have a system put in place where all they really care about is the corporate world and the wealthiest people in the country, you know, padding their pockets with as much money as possible, they're not gonna care or listen to the concerns of anyone in the working class or middle class, right? You're tired of hearing about it? Here's who's not tired of hearing about it. The people who are making like $7, $8 an hour and can't come anywhere close to a living wage. Right now, a living wage in America in most major metropolitan areas is $15 an hour. We're having a conversation about $10.10 an hour. It's still not anywhere near where it needs to be for a living wage.
The U.S. federal wage floor ranks third lowest.
Republican governor of New Jersey is sick and tired of hearing about one particular issue. Let's listen to the governor. So right there, he makes clear that it shouldn't be an issue because nobody should aspire to it. Well, yeah, I guess, I mean, nobody wants to be in the hospital, but we should care about the insurance industry. It's just stupidity there, and he's going to be attacked for it. But first, what's your response?
Yeah, I think that this goes to how much our politicians are stuck in their elite bubble.
Yes.
So for them, the only contact they have with anyone who's ever made minimum wage is their kids. So, like, maybe, oh, you know, instead of just handing Johnny a BMW, let's make him work for it. Let's make him go work at McDonald's and get minimum one.
Yeah.
So that's going to be our new champ. We're number 31!
Well, I think with a president, Chris Christie, I think we could get to 34 out of 34.
Woo,
yeah, I think it's partially what you said about the sort of ignorance and the expectation that you would only be in that position if you knew, if you're, like, slumming it for a little while, I guess. But I think it might be a little bit more insidious than that. I mean, if you really look into the way, the words that Republicans, the conservatives, I should say, use to describe the world, it's the economic system is tied in with their system of morality. And I don't think it's just that they think that those people, if they tried a little bit harder, could get out of it. I think it's that they genuinely dislike those people. They think you are failures, you're losers, you have no ambition. They don't want it to be easier for failures. Failures are immoral. They are dirty, corrupt people. It should be bad for them. That's why they like the system of heaven and hell. They want punishment for the people who go against their moral system. That's why they like the prison system so much. They want it to be crappy. They don't want it to be better. They don't want it to be Sweden's prison system. They want you to be punished if you fail. And so if you end up working at a minimum wage job for whatever reason, because you had to drop out of school so that you could take care of your parents, or you had a disease and you lost all your money so you couldn't go to law school, whatever, you're a failure, you deserve to be punished. It shouldn't be 10-10, it shouldn't be 7, it should be $1 if that's what they want to pay you, because you don't deserve any more.
So one last thing that I get out of it is that, and I'm going to use a weird analogy here, the Joan Rivers analogy, right? Before she passed away and they asked her about the Israeli incursion into Gaza and how thousands had died and most of them were civilians, and she said, I refuse to be bothered by that. right? Oh. And so you're not going to get me to feel bad about that. Okay, well, congratulations to you. So, and I have the same sense here from Chris Christie. Like, you're not going to get me to be bothered by people making minimum wage, which is only $7.25 nationally, right? I don't care about those people. Whether it's malicious or it's not malicious, I don't care. And I've already made it. And all of my friends and all of my donors have already made it. So we refuse.